Today, I'll show you how to implement an input autocomplete feature using Fuzzy Search. To put things in practice, we will create this page, where a list of suggestions will show while you type a browser name. I'm Lucas Paganini, and in this channel, we release web development tutorials. Subscribe if you're interested in that. We also publish our content as articles on our website. You can subscribe to our newsletter to be notified when we launch a course, post a video, or write an article. What is a Fuzzy search? A Fuzzy search searches for text that matches a term approximately instead of exactly. In an exact search, com would never match Chrome because there is no com in Chrome. There is no room for interpretation. It's either true or false. That, of course, is not very human friendly. If we're searching for something, there's a chance that we might not even know how to spell it correctly. Fuzzy search is a lot more flexible. Instead of true or false, we have degrees of truth. A Fuzzy search will tell us how close two strings are. There are many Fuzzy search algorithms. As an educational example, let me show you a very simple Fuzzy search algorithm called Hamming distance. Given two strings with the same length, the Hamming distance between them is the minimal number of substitutions required to change one string into the other. For example, the Hamming distance between Daniel and Denise is 3, because we would have to change 3 letters for them to match. We could implement a Fuzzy search mechanism that calculates the Hamming distance between the search keyword and all the possible results, and then we would sort the results, showing the ones with the lowest Hamming distance first. Of course, that would be a terrible user experience, since our algorithm only works with strings that have the same length. But it's a valid example. It uses the Hamming distance to determine how close two strings are. In practice, you have to choose the Fuzzy search algorithm that best suits your needs. Most of the time, you will simply look for the most performant one. But other times, you might choose an algorithm based on some specialized features. For example, there is a Fuzzy search algorithm that can search strings based on their phonetics, which might be more important than performance, depending on your use case. You also need to consider how much data you're dealing with. If you want to perform a Fuzzy search in a huge dataset, doing it in the frontend is probably not the best idea. Even if your end users have a lot of computational power, they would need to download the whole dataset to run the search in the frontend. Also, running searches in the backend gives you a lot more options. The two most popular are Elasticsearch and Algolia. In this video, we will be dealing with a small dataset, so we will run our search in the frontend. A simple way to add autocomplete to an input element is to use a data list. This doesn't even require any JavaScript. Just HTML. The search algorithm is pretty fast. It uses exact search, removes spaces, and ignores the case sensitivity. But there is a deal breaker. The search algorithm is not customizable, and neither are the list styles. So that clearly won't work for real-world projects, where we have a custom design to comply to. That's why we're going to create a custom component instead of using a data list. For our Fuzzy search algorithm, I chose to use Fuse.js. It's performant, well-documented, and actively maintained. I did everything with pure HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. I didn't want to use a framework for this example to avoid unnecessary complexity. I'm leaving a link to the code in the video description. You'll see that there's no compilation process. I'm just serving the files in the public folder. My constants are set in the config.mjs file. The custom dropdown element is declared in the dropdown element MJS file. Our Fuzzy search function using Fuse.js is defined in the Fuzzy search MJS file, and the main MJS file connects everything. It's listening to changes in our input, running the Fuzzy search, and displaying the results. Fuse.js provides a lot of options, and they are all very descriptive. Pay special attention to the threshold option. It controls how close a string should be for a match to happen. Setting it to 0 is the same as using an exact search, and setting it to 1 would match anything. As always, references are in the description. Play with the code base and feel free to leave a comment if you have any questions. If this video was helpful, please leave a like and consider subscribing to the channel for more web development tutorials. And if your company is looking for remote web developers, consider contacting me and my team on lucaspaganini.com. Have a great day, and I will see you in the next one.